The iTIG3 Model A includes insulation resistance or MEGO measurements, DC high pot, and the surge test. We'll demonstrate those features on this 2 horsepower, 460 volt, three-phase stator. To get started, you click start. We get to our setup screen. We have the high pot and surge test voltage formulas. The instrument will default to 2 times the operating voltage plus 1000. There's an extra multiplier here at the end of 1. If you want to change any of the fields, you can do so, operating voltage being an obvious one. So let's say this was a 415 volt instead of 460. You would enter in 415, hit enter, and it will calculate your new test voltages based on the formula. If you just want to change the test voltage itself, you can do so as well. Okay, next thing here, we have the overcurrent tripout level. So that's essentially a safety feature during the mega ohm and high pots test. If the leakage current exceeds, in this case, 1000 microamps, we'll shut off the test. Next up here, we'll be moving from left to right, is the mega ohm measurement. Before we start that test, we need to connect our lead set. So the A model has the high voltage leads. It will have 3 high voltage leads labeled 1, 2, and 3, plus a ground clip. Take the ground clip and connect it to an unpainted clean surface on the frame of the motor. This little bolt is good, for example. And then lead 1 to phase 1 and lead 2 to phase 2 and lead 3 to phase 3. Okay, so now we're connected and ready to start the test. So we're going to start with our mega ohm measurements. To do so, we will press the red button. It will say high voltage on. And now you turn the silver dial clockwise to your desired test voltage. In this case, for low voltage motors, let's take it up to about 500 volts. You can see the leakage current is decreasing as the polarization dissipates. It will calculate your mega ohms. And you can let it sit here for a minute or longer or shorter, whatever you prefer. I'm going to shut it off here. Automatically discharges the windings. The information bar turns blue. We're safe to move on. Next step here is the high pot test. Very similar to the insulation resistance or mega ohm. We'll press the red button. High voltage is on. And you now use the silver dial to increase the voltage. It will say down here what our design test voltage is based on the voltage formula we saw on the previous page. So I'm going to turn this slowly up to 1830, or at least close. And then we can let it sit there. The timer is running, so you can keep track of how long you're sitting at your test voltage. Or you can just say, okay, there are no arcs, the leakage current is low, it's still decreasing slightly. This is looking fine. Press the red button, shut off the test, automatically de-energize the windings. Information bar is blue, we're safe to move on. Last up here is the surge test. Lead 1, it will be the first one to be energized. You arm the instrument, press the red button. It will automatically set the time base and voltage scale, drive the voltage up to our design test voltage, 2000 volts in this case. And you'll do the same for phase 2. Arm the instrument, press the button. Phase 3, arm the instrument, press the button. And you now have your 3 surge waveforms for the 3 phases. As you can tell, these are almost identical. So they're overlapping. It's hard to tell that we have 3 traces on the screen, but you get the percent wave differences listed on the top here. In this case, we got 2.1% difference between phase 1 and 2, and lead, excuse me, phase two and three and three and one were both less than 2%. At any rate, they're all very nice, low percentages. There are no reasons to expect any issues here.